Thanks, Vishal. Thanks. Your maiden performance has been amazing. It's like what Ravi Shastri used to do in the Benson and Hedges World Cup, in case some of you are that old to remember, where he won an Audi and stuff like that. So, some of you may be thinking, Vishal is talking about three things: 920 strategy, momentum trading, and STBT, right? Are those the three things you talked about? So, there's also another option. You have a friendly guy from Indore who promises 99% returns. Why not? Okay, just kidding. I'm sure. Is there anybody here who has not got a call from Indore? No, sir. We're taking questions later on. Meaning, you know, it'll be done offline because we're late for the next session already. But quickly, wrapping up. So, ignore my question. We'll do that in the next session. Thanks a lot, Vishal.
I hope this was useful from my end.
Show of hands. Beautiful. Great. Thanks a lot, Vishal. Yeah. So, now we're going to have something which under-promises and over-delivers. Some of you, or a lot of you, especially on YouTube, would have heard the name of Shariq Shamsuddin. He is from Kerala. He is an option seller, and one can equate him to the Rahul Dravid style of selling. Because with some people, we have seen the Virender Sehwag kind of batting. That is, their concept would be see ball, hit ball kind of thing. So here it's going to be different, much different. And can we have Shariq, please? How many of you were at Goa last? Okay, so good number. So you might already remember Shariq. It's hardly a few months now. So we're going to have another session by him. We have a newer audience as well. And after this session, we're going to have the lunch break. But this session, okay, all the sessions, probably I'm biased towards everybody on the stage here. So all of them give you quality content. So that is something that can be assured about. Over to Shariq.
perspective. People don't think like this. So I never talk about premiums. I never talk about what's happening in the market, what strategy you're using. P&L is the ultimate thing in the market. So the people say that, hey, you have to look at Greeks. I say option premium already discounts Greeks. Then people say, look at option premium. I say, my P&L has already discounted option premium. My P&L speaks to me. I am in this market. I am trading options. I am selling options because I know what my capital is. I am running a business. At the end of the week, this much money I need from the market. And for that, I can lose this much. I don't know what I'm doing in between. And it can be done in a very simple manner. Trust me on this. I mean, anybody sitting here can follow my system and make 1% a week, 4% a month. I've been doing it, I mean, for a very long time now. Last time we met in Goa, it's been 6 months. I've made more than 36% over the last 6 months. And that's how it is going for me. So yeah, it's all about perspective. What you want out of trading, why you're existing, what you want out of the market. Just think about that, and I'm sure things will be very clear. When I come to the carnival, one thing which entices me is, I go out, I see people standing in circles. Everybody wants to understand a new strategy, a new trick. Then they see someone else standing there, they go over there. Hey sir, what is your strategy? What is your trick? No point in doing all of those things. It's just about knowing what you do and getting the returns that you're happy with. So if that is clear, things should be very easy. And this is what we're going to talk about today. Making 50% returns a year with weekly index option selling. Weekly index option selling, not intraday, it is going to be positional. You're going to carry overnight positions. You're going to make 50% returns a year. I've been doing it. I can show my P&L. We can do that review because option sellers, they eat like ants and shit like elephants. Right? Last 6 months, we can do a proper review. There was a week where I lost 14 lakh rupees, which is, I don't know, more than 10% of my capital. Still standing on top of 36% returns over the last 6 months. Right? So it can be done is what I'm saying. Right. So making 50% returns a year with weekly index option sale, that's just Nifty and Bank Nifty for you. Now you ask me what my fucking perspective is. Sorry. Yeah? What is my perspective in the market? Yeah? We all talked about making thousands of crores in our lifetime. You happy with that? I'll just give my calculation, which is practical to me. I'm not sure if it can be practical to you. You can do your own calculation. Say I'm trading with 3 crore rupees of capital. Okay? I'm making 1% a week. That is 4% a month. That is by through like weekly index option selling, which is simple. So I'm making 12 lakh rupees a month. I'm taking 10 lakh rupees out of that and I'm putting into a freaking mutual fund, which is giving me 15% returns per annum. And I do that, a 10 lakh rupees SIP for the next 30 years. Any guesses how much that will be? It is over 3,000 crores. Happy? Why do you have to chase behind some out of the world strategy where you have to sit in front of the system, where you have to be majorly discretionary, where you have to make a lot of decisions, where you have to speculate on the market, where you have to take a lot of stress? Do a simple thing, which is giving you 1% a week. And again, the numbers are based on a capital of 3 CR. And after 30 years, I'll be here. Probably, DJ, are you here? There will be Traders Carnival even then, and probably I'll be on stage then as well, and we'll see then, right? That's going to happen for sure. And in between, my capital would increase, my stock picking would increase so that my long-term portfolio would probably give more than 20%. Let's focus on that as well. So for me, perspective, guys, perspective. For me, perspective is trading is an income-generating tool. I run a business, I make income from that. I have a YouTube channel, I have income from that. I do trading, which is another business. I have an income from that. Say at the end of the month, I have 15, 20, I don't know. That's my income. And then I use long-term investment to grow my wealth. Trading is just an income-generating tool. This is my perspective. And I'm just pitching it to you guys. If you kind of appreciate that perspective, you can definitely take that trade. We'll all be sitting on top of thousands of crores. I mean, I understand the kind of crowd we have here and the kind of capital I said can be meager to a lot of you, right? So let's do that. Anyway, so that's something. Now, I haven't talked about myself, right? I know DJ gave me a small introduction where I am Rahul Dravid, which I am. So I am Shariksham Sudhin. I come from Kerala. I'm a weekly index option seller. So when Vishal says it, that he's a system-based trader, I always thought I'm a system-based trader, but the system is in my mind. I think that it makes me a discretionary trader, right? So that's what I am, I guess, right? So I've graduated from NIT Jamshedpur. I have had a startup earlier. I sold the startup. I worked with a few startups after which, and then I started trading, right? So I've taught a lot of people about the markets for free on YouTube, and that's changed a lot of things for me. I also founded and run a company called MarketFeed, where we are trying to build a social trading platform. In fact, we got into Y Combinator, which is a US-based startup accelerator. We got into Y Combinator's latest batch, after which we raised a VC seed funding of $2.2 million. So I'm building a company at the same time. So I'm not a full-time trader. I'm just a passive trader who's trying to make some 1,000 crores of market in 1,000 crores of money by passively trading in the market. So there are a lot of active traders, full-time traders here, right? So think about the scope that you have. It's all about perspective, guys. Right. So yeah, I mean, I happen to have given a TEDx talk also. Cool. Right. So why option selling? So I don't think Vishal has already given a nice marketing presentation for option selling, so I don't think I should get into it. But I have another framework where I think about option selling, which is, in order to make money in intraday equity buying, shorting, future buying, shorting, in option buying, you have to sort out the first thing, which is, where will the underlying go? You have to be absolutely right about that, right? You have to be absolutely right about where will Nifty go, where will Bank Nifty go. Only then you can make money in the market. But in option selling, you just have to have an idea of where will the underlying not go to. Do you feel the difference? To make money in buying, you have to be sure, or even short selling, you have to be absolutely sure about where will the underlying go to. And in the second case, which is option selling, you just have to have an idea of, hey, Nifty wouldn't probably go to 18,300 next week. Nifty wouldn't probably go to 17,000 next week, and you end up making money, right? So that's higher probabilities like Vishal talked about. And target-oriented trading for everybody. Option selling can be done by almost everyone sitting here. Almost everyone sitting here can make 1% a week. Not everyone can do option buying and succeed like the masters of the game. So that's one major differentiator there. Moving ahead. So quickly getting into the strategy, I would be completely telling what I do normally. Probably you understand that. So again, repeating this is not intraday, purely positional. And as again Vishal said, there's a lot of similarities here. I'll quickly go to the entry here. So I enter on a Tuesday. For a weekly expiry, which is happening on the Thursday, I enter on Tuesday. That's all. I, again, don't trade on Mondays and Fridays. Sometimes I enter into intraday straddles, strangles, but mostly, you know, I have a company to run. I have other stuff to do. So why not, right? Trade for three days in a week. Make that 1%, be happy. Perspective is met. Our target is met. So anyways, coming back into the strategy, pretty simple. Nothing major here. It's all about the perspective, but again, laying it out to those who do not know it, right? So basically, it's selling an iron condor, right? So Tuesday morning, market open. So why Tuesday again? As he said, theta decay is the maximum on a Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. And why not a Monday? Monday is also good for theta decay. Why not a Monday? Because the US markets open only after our markets close on a Monday. So I want confirmation what has happened over the weekend in the US market. So I'll wait and see what has happened in the US markets on Tuesday morning. I'll be seeing and I'll be coming into a speculation that where will Nifty not go up to and where will Nifty not go down to by the expiry. Everybody can say that? On a Tuesday morning, expiry is 2 days away. Just one question in your mind. How much up will Nifty not go to by expiry? How much down will Nifty not go to by expiry? Can be done, right? Very simple. Pretty much everybody who has a basic understanding of the market can tell that is what I believe. So you have that. So you, whichever level you think in the higher side, you sell a call option. Whichever level you think on the lower side, you sell a put option. You hedge both with a 150 points away call and put. Definitely required. 150, keep it like that. It will actually maximize your returns. Probably a lot of people do not talk about that. So anyways, only weekly expiry, equal number of lots of call and put. I do only in Nifty and mostly calls. As I try to have more balance in calls, but now I have completely changed into a non-directional player. So it's equal calls and puts. So the magic of credit spread is something people do not understand. I should probably go to a strategy builder and show that, right? So this is an internal tool that we have. Okay, So what do you think? By next Thursday, which is my expiry, will Nifty expire? It hasn't come yet. Can you sort it out? Yeah, I've changed my screen, but... Yeah? Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Was that also with the
hedge? Yeah, it was with the hedge. Yeah. But again, multiple discretions going wrong, right? Yeah.
Okay. So my question was that when he had the drawdown, was that also with the hedge?
Right, right. It was right. With the hedge. Yes.
Okay, great.
Right.
Superb. Thanks.
Is it happening? Yeah, is it happening? Okay, so I'll just tell it, guys. So what I look into when I enter is not the premium, right? It's not there anyways, yeah. It's not the premium, right? So what I think, as I said earlier, is how much up will Nifty not go up to by the next expiry? Say I'm asking the question now. What do you think? Will Nifty go up till 18,250 next expiry, which is Thursday? 18,250? Chances are less. So you can sell a call option there, and what it will give you is 0.82% of your capital. That is what I look into when I enter a trade. Always I look into what I get after entering the trade, not in absolute terms at all. I know whatever capital is to be deployed, on that capital, I'll get 0.82% is what the strategy builder is saying. So normally what people do is they just sell a 8250 calls. But what I say is you hedge it with a 18400 calls, and do you think how much the returns will be on the capital deployed? Any idea? Any guesses? It will go up to 1.15%. I mean, do you feel the magic there? So if you always think in returns perspective, so people think, why do you hedge? You asked about hedge, right? You always think as a hedge as something which will protect you from losses. Never. Hedges are not meant for that, is what I believe. Hedges to give you higher returns, always. So I have seen a lot of traders who are hedging with 500, 600 points away, thinking that that will protect them. But again, that will not increase your returns. So hedges should always be done for increasing the returns that you can get. Always think in returns perspective, right? Yeah, and that's done, so we'll anyways move. But if you can sort this, is good, because I'll have to show something. Oh, okay, okay, please, please. So meanwhile, maybe we can take some questions, if any. Cool. Yeah.
You mentioned only calls.
Oh, that's a mistake. That's what I said. It's both calls and puts, equal quantity.
Okay.
Equal quantity of both calls and puts. Okay. Yeah. I'll make that change before I share it with all of you. Yeah.
Yeah, one thing. So like you said, right, you're making an assumption that market will not go.
Yeah.
So do you concentrate on particular premium every time, or are you going to see this any kind of reversal or support resistance kind of all the maximum points kind of
for thing. Adjusting?
No, for the initiate the trade.
For the initial, yeah, that's what I said. So I do not look at, say, Shreyas was talking about standard deviation. Huh. So you're talking about supports and resistance. Huh. I look into returns.
Okay, so
because I'm doing a business, what I should get back is returns.
So you are saying that you are go into the trade where you will going to get 1%.
Yes, on a Tuesday morning, whichever trade gives me, say 0.8%. I don't even take a 1% trade on a Tuesday, because 1% is I need Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. So Tuesday I enter a 0.8% trade. Wednesday, Thursday I can exit that. I can bring down my legs. That'll end up giving me 1% just like that. Yesterday opening I was sitting on top of 1%, but since we were on stage, I had to do something, so I took it up. Right.
I have a question.
Okay. Thank you.
Sharik?
Yeah.
So on one side, is there a stop loss that you keep for the spread that you capture? Like example, on the call side,
uh-huh.
What is the stop loss that you keep for that spread?
Yeah, I'll definitely come to stop loss. Yes, there is the stop loss. I mean, the money management is awesome. There was a Chrome tab. Everything's gone. Oh, it's gone. I mean, I had a lot of things opened up. Cool, cool. Anyways, I mean, we can move ahead. Right. Cool. So So that's one major point that should be focused on, which is magic of credit spread, which is having a hedge just to increase your returns. So no one thinks like this is what I've seen in the market. No one looks into the returns before entering it. So you think about selling an 18-250 calls because you think you can eat that premium. But you pay some premium as the hedge, which is in fact reducing your absolute returns, but that is increasing your profit percentage, the percentage return. So that's major, right? So yeah, the strike price selection, so that's very simple. Which strike price to sell? Whichever you think on a Tuesday morning, where Nifty will not go up to, that's your call sell strike price. Where Nifty will not go down till Thursday, that's your put sell strike price. Very simple. So next week, say if you are entering a trade, I would be selling a 18-250 call down. I don't know, I don't have the strategy builder now. Otherwise, we could have worked it out. Say a 17,000 put would be giving that. Right, so that's something that we find out, and I have a famous four-point analysis that I do to do that. So I look into the global markets, any local data, news, anything to be announced in the coming week. I look into OI analysis I do. I look into price action-based supports and resistance. I also look into index heavyweights movements, because Nifty and Bank Nifty is nothing but index heavyweights. Right? So I look into them as well. So do all of those, and on a Tuesday morning, I go into a strategy builder. I see by doing which call sell and which put sell, and buying which 150 points away call and which 150 points away put, I'm getting 0.8% on a Tuesday morning. That is my entry. I hope that is clear. If any question, we can clear it then and there and we can move ahead. Is the entry very clear? Tuesday morning, whichever trade you think Nifty will not go up to and Nifty will not go down to, sell a call, sell a put, buy a call 150 points up, sell a put 150 points down, whichever is giving you 0 point returns on your capital. That is the metric I track. Note which premium am I selling it. Cool, I hope that's clear. Yeah, which strike to buy is what can give you the best return, which I have said in simple words, which is 150 points away is the hedge. Right. And this is the simple iron contour. I'm sure you all know what it is. And the entry, as we've already covered, is on Tuesday. And the exit. Now, this is where things get tricky, right? So maybe market can make a very strong move on one side, and that's when you shit your pants and things go bad, right? So the exit is where the game is. So entry is very simple. Anybody can do this, is what I think. And there's also a saying which goes around saying that option sellers, it's very easy for them to make money. Theta DK will give them money. God will give them money. They just have to sell a strangle and sit there, and God will give them money. But it's very funny, right? But yesterday was a live example of an option seller putting his work in to make money in the market. So Shreyas and yeah, so he would probably understand. So yesterday we did a lot of work to make money. Anyways, that's not the point. So what I'm saying is, as an option seller, note this down. As an option seller, most of the times, you do not have to do work to make money. You have to do work to reduce your losses, and you'll win. Yeah, you have to do work to reduce your losses. That's it. So when the position goes bad, you have to go in front of your system. You have to do a lot of work. If it's all going good, like Shreyas is sitting now, his position is running quite nicely today. So he's sitting there chilling. So option seller has to do work when the position is going bad to manage his position, to come out profitability or cut down his short. So that's the, again, the mindset and the perspective you should have. So the exit, again, exit can be when you're profitable or when you're loss-making, right? If you're making profits, if that leg has given you near maximum profit, you can exit. Make sense? You entered that trade expecting 1% of your capital. Maybe by Thursday morning, there was a move in that another direction and there was enough theta DKs. You've already gotten 0.8% from that trade only. Why would you sit in that strike anymore? So you can lower that call down. So profit booking or target booking is our near max profit. Otherwise, there's another target also. Another closer strike with higher returns and same safety. Do you understand that? So say we sold a 18-250 call today. And Nifty is moving down, or by Tuesday we have a clear indication that it's a very bearish channel, and Nifty is never going to come up to 18,000 even. And 18,250 still has a lot of money to give to you, But you can simply close that position and move down to 18,000. You need not wait in 18,250 anymore. Is that clear? If another strike price, a closer strike price, is giving you higher returns and same safety, you can move your strikes. And that too, when you move, for the money management in the strategy to work out, always make sure that you never enter a trade which is giving you more than 1% returns. If you enter, say, something happened and you're seeing a good trade which is giving you 2%, so whenever you are entering a trade, go to a strategy builder and see how much returns it is giving you. So if you're entering a 2% trade, after entering a 0.8% trade in the first day, it's going to mess up with your money management, so never do that. A 0.8% trade and a 1% trade overall, whenever, whichever trade you're entering. So that's when you book profits. Next, let's come to what matters the most, which is loss booking. So number one, SL is very simple. Your analysis has changed. So something suddenly has happened in the market. It's moving up. You have a call short. So you can absolutely close the position. Maybe there's a good news in the market. And if there is a good news, there's no point in holding on to anymore. And I got a great example from that guy. Hey, him. Yeah, I forgot your name, but yeah? Pranav. Param. Yeah, so Param said a great example last Traders Carnival. So you have a call short, you're sure nothing will happen. So what if Narendra Modi marries Sonia Gandhi, right? Right? You said that, right? I remember that. So I still use it. So anything can happen in the market. So what I'm saying is, that is your analysis getting changed. You thought Nifty will never go up to 18,250. That's why you have sold an 18,250 calls. But now your analysis has changed because of this event. So you exit the position. But that's again, doesn't happen a lot. But the next one is my Bible. I don't know what I go to, which saves my system, which is my SL of 3x max profit. I don't know the premium because the money I make is the difference between my sell and buy. Yeah? So what I know is, in a trade, I can get 1% from one side, say from one side. If the loss is reaching 3x of that, I will exit. No, I'll come to that. No, that's beauty of money management. I'll be actually showing it on Excel, which I'm not sure if I can. I mean, Excel. No, so that's the beauty, right? It's a 1% trade overall. So what are you getting from the top side? 0.5% of total capital. What are you getting from, I mean, he's actually decoded it, so I'll tell it anyway, so I'll come to that. That's the beauty of the strategy. It's amazing. I mean, I know, I built it and I'm saying it's amazing, but it's amazing. I'll come to that. But again, I hope you understand.
Leg 4 square off order placed in 03/9/2021 PE38800.
Profit and loss in the business. Yeah. So that's where you have to limit the loss, nothing more than that. You can even cut it short before that. It's up to you. It's your discretion. But nothing more than 3x max profit. And I can write it and give it to you. You'll never lose with the strategy. Right? So this is the adjustments and firefight you can do afterwards. That is when you're so call and a put. Say market moved up. Your call is in loss. But to the SL like this to get hit, what do you think? It's very difficult. Yeah, for this SL, which is a crazy SL, you're entering on a Tuesday with a premium of, say, 12. For it to go to probably 50 range, so 40 range, it's not 12 into 3 because that's the credit spread is there. So for the 12 to go to 40 is very difficult, right? It happens very once in a while. And for such, and even when such an SL is hit,
So is the credit spread a separate thing or it's part of like the same strategy where you're selling current week and buying of same week only?
Same week.
So where does the credit... Oh, it's a credit spread, right?
It's you're an earning, iron condor, right?
You're earning
on one
money.
Side is the credit Perfect. Spread.
Perfect. Thank yeah. you. I was thinking of calendar and getting a little
No. It's the same expiry.
Same.
It's the same
Superb.
Expiry.
Thank you.
Yeah, sure. So that SL itself is very difficult for it to get hit. There has to be crazy move in the market for that SL to be hit, right? And say, this is a call that you have sold, this is the put you have sold, markets moved up, SL is not hit, but you feel that your put is safe now, you got some profits here, you move up your puts, right? Then the market moved down after sometimes, market, it's bound to happen in the market, you move down your call. And that's how your 0.8% trade on a Tuesday morning becomes a 1% trade by the end of the week. So I hope this adjustments and firefight is clear, and now let's see power of money management if I can get Excel here. Excuse me. Hello? Yeah, excuse me. Excuse me. Still not up. Sure. So now let's do this activity, right? Yeah? This is a practical example and seeing how money management can do wonders to the strategy. Say Nifty is at 18,000. Example. Okay? It's a Tuesday morning. What do we enter? Let's say we are entering a 1% trade. Cool. So again, it's an example. I'm selling an 18,500 call and a 17,500 put. All okay? And obviously, I have a 18650 call here, which is buy, same expiry, same number of lots, and a 17350 put, same expiry, same number of lots. Yeah, this is clear. This is what we enter, right? And let's not have the buy legs anymore. I hope that's very clear that we'll always have buy legs. Even if you're exiting, we'll exit the buy legs. We're entering a new position, we'll enter a new buy leg also. So I'll take it out of the equation to make it very simple. I said this is a 1% trade. So what do you think of the total capital will I get from 18,500 CE? Answers, please. How much returns of my capital will I get on the day of expiry if everything goes well with 18,500 call option? 0.5%, who said that? Yeah, on the day of expiry, we'll anyways get 0.5%. Cool. And how much percentage returns of our capital will we get from the 17,500 PE? 0.5%. That's how this is a strategy where we're getting 1% of our capital in a week. Cool. Right. So best case is everything goes well. On a Thursday, we get 0.5 from here. You get a 0.5 from here. I'm talking about a trader who's not even actively trading. He entered on a Tuesday. Things are staying there. You do not do any work at all. You make this 1% and remember about the thousands of crores you can make with this, given the capital, right? Anyway, so now you add this up, and this is how you get the this auto sum. Yeah. So this is how you get the 1% a week. Very clear? Now we talked about, and it's all about risk management, right? We talked about a very crazy SL. Yeah? A very, very crazy SL of 3 times of maximum profit, whose probability is very less to hit. Because we're entering on a Tuesday, this is Thursday, probability of an SL getting hit is super, super less. But MTM swings we'll have to see. But that we should be okay with that. If you're ready to see MTM swings, and if you can hold on to your 3x SL, let's take that scenario. Okay? Nifty crashed to say 17,600. That is where your 3x SL would probably be hit if that crash happens, that too on a Wednesday. Even if it's happening on a Thursday, your 3x SL will not be hit. That's the beauty. Say Nifty went down till there and say SL hit. Okay? How much, important question, how much percentage of your capital will you be losing on that day? Who said that? Minus 1.5%. Yeah? And you are a foolish trader. You don't know what to do. You did not roll down your calls. You just sat there like a fool. How much are you making from the 18,500 calls? 0.5%. What is the risk reward of the strategy? What is the risk reward of the strategy? Please. It's 1:1, right? Yeah? So it's 1:1. And what is the probability for this to win? Let's even keep it at 60%, 70%. I mean, I know it's even more than 90%. But let's keep it at 80%. So a strategy which can win 80% plus times, having a risk reward of 1:1. When you are a foolish trader, this is without adjustments, my dear friends. Yeah, well, that's there. But this is without adjustments is what I'm saying. I could have ended up like this yesterday with a 1% loss. Did I? Now, This is something anybody can do. This is something which can be coded. This is something which can be made into a systems-based trade. Now, this is where a good trader can come in and make sure that he's not even losing this 1%, right? So what can be done there? So when this happens on a Wednesday afternoon, he can roll down his call. So he can book a 0.4% from here. He can roll down his calls to an 18,300 CE, which can probably give him another 0.5%. And capital is freed from here also, right? Because SL is it, capital is freed. He can, based on his conviction, he can go down and sell probably a 17,200 PE. That can give him probably another 0.4%. So you add all this up, right? Yeah, how much are you getting? 0.4. You hold this till expiry. Given you're not doing any more adjustments. Now what is this? Now what is the risk reward? I say the risk reward of my setup is, I mean, I don't know, loss is very limited, but the profits can be higher and the probability is like too high. 80-90% is the probability of winning, and yeah, this is what I do. Very simple, making just 1% a week, making sure that you're not losing more than 1% a week, and also by adjusting and firefighting, also making sure that you're never losing any week at all. But when you are a discretionary trader, that tends to happen. You end up taking more trades and that goes into loss, and that's when a system can go into loss. But again, so with Vishal, I had a great conversation with Vishal, right? If I had coded this, if I would have made this into a system, this would have easily given me what? 4 into 6, 25, 24% over the last 6 months. For sure. 24% for sure in the last 6 months. But I made nearly 36% over the last 6 months. Even by booking 14 lakhs loss in a week. So that's all discretion. So discretion, some weeks can give you higher profits, some week can give you higher losses as well, but it's all up to you. I mean, it's up to you if you want to follow discretion or if you want to code this. So that's it majorly, yeah.
We didn't mention that hedging options.
What is it?
Hedging.
Yeah, hedges are always there. So hedges are always there. So you move the hedges also. So when the 17,500 put had a 17,350 put as a hedge, when you exited completely. Then you sell a 17,200 put, you have a 17,050 put as well, as the hedge.
Okay. Then how money management will work here?
So that's why I always say in terms of percentage returns, right? It's because you come from a different school of thought where you look into premiums. You know hedges are eating your money, right? That's what you think.
Yeah, yeah.
That is a completely wrong thought, guys. Hedges are never eating your money. Okay, let me see if I can show the strategy builder here.
Shariq, one question.
Yeah.
When you say 0.5% premium,
yeah,
that is after reducing
0.5% of?
Capital.
Of capital is our returns, yeah.
Yeah, so that is after reducing the premium paid on the buy side.
Yeah, yeah, yes.
So it has to be, for example, you may get 0.7% on the sell side, one sell side, and 0.2 on the buy side. So net is 0.5 on one side, right?
Yes, right.
The total has to come to
0.8. Total, total, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Thank you.
Right. So, yeah, this is what I'm talking about, right? So I'm not sure. Okay, let's move a bit ahead. So, yeah, so 18,300 as of now. So 18,300 is giving you 0.75% returns of your capital. Always think like this if you are an option seller. What returns are you getting on the capital deployed? So you're getting 0.75% if you sell 18,300 calls. What if I say, and I'm going to say that I'm going to hedge this. And you might say, since we are going to hedge it, our returns is going to decrease. Yeah? I cannot digest it. So that's the beauty when you hedge it, right? So when you hedge it with an 18,450, see what happens to the returns. See what happens to the returns. Hedge is a tool with which you can increase your returns. Hedge do not take your money away. Hedges give you more money. It decreases your absolute returns, but increases your percentage returns. Always focus on percentage returns. Never look into absolutes at all, right? Always, always percentages, right? So make 1% a week. Do not lose more than 1% a week.
Plus, it also helps, Shariq Vivek here. It also helps from black swans, which can't predict.
So that is, so people think that is the largest use. But how many times do a black swan happen? Right. So this is a larger use case, and black swan is definitely there. Yeah, so even if a black swan happens, since we are entering just a 1% trade, the maximum we are going to lose is only 15% of the capital. 15% of the capital is you will ever lose, and that's what you make in 3 months. Aren't you okay to give away 3 months of profits in case of a black swan event? Absolutely okay. So the maximum... Yeah, this is not an iron condor, right? So if you build an iron condor, it would be half of this. Half of 28, because half of the capital is deployed, right?
Again, technically, this is not exactly what it... It might be lower because the wings will also start expanding in wall.
Right.
This is theoretically only, but this is not true. Yeah. The real losses are much lower.
Much?
Lower.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So 14% is the max you can ever lose in case of any Sonia Gandhi event, right? So that's it. So again, coming back to this, hedges. Now, a lot of people actually hedge with the even far OTM so that you think you're spending less on hedge, right? Want to see what happens there? You hedge with, I don't know, 500 points away.
It's required higher margin.
What is it? Market mood? Market mood. Okay. So normally the returns go down a lot. So never think as to reduce your hedge amount to increase your returns. It never happens. Always go to a strategy builder and take it from me, from my years of experience, 150 points away hedge is the best hedge you can ever have. It can protect you. It'll give you the highest returns. And that's it. That's the best hedge you can ever have. 150 points away. Yeah.
SL in this case.
What?
SL.
So this is a trade I'll never take, right? I'll also have a put. This is just call, right?
You put SL at a premium of 390 in case of 18,300.
Let me bring it back to my actual buy. Yeah, let's talk.
Okay. So what is the SL in this case?
SL. In this side alone.
Yeah.
The maximum, say you're just deploying 25,000, that's your capital, right? Okay. The maximum profit you can get is 302 rupees. 900 rupees is your SL.
9 rupees.
900
is?
SL and profit is on your P&L. It's not on the premium, it's not on the index, at least according to my system, it's on your P&L. And it's not automated, you watch your P&L, you set an alert on your P&L, and then you go and manually exit the position. So you exit when your SL hits, which is your P&L shows 900 rupees of loss.
Okay, got it.
Because you're doing a business at the end of the day. You don't care what the variables inside are. What you care is the returns that you get. Can be profit or loss. You just look into that. That'll tell the entire story. That is what you have to control at the end of the day. Right?
Right. Thank you.
Yeah.
A practical problem is my discount broker doesn't
allow you to buy far out of the money options. Yeah?
Yeah, he doesn't allow to buy
far out of the money options.
Yeah.
Kick away that broker and get a new broker. Why are you emotionally attached to a broker? I mean, is there...
No, the situation is same with every broker or...
Never. Just with Zerodha, right? You're talking about Zerodha, I know that. Zerodha never allows you to buy a far out of the money option, so don't use Zerodha. As simple as that. I mean, I answered like that because that is the single largest question I ever receive as an option seller. Zerodha doesn't allow to buy far out of the notions. What can we do? Right. Espresso guys are here. You want a plug here? Right. They're not here. Yeah. I think I'm done. Let me see. So. Right. So we saw the power of money management. So that's the largest thing here. And yeah, I would love to end with perspective, which is to be true, you start targeting 1%. But you end up making 2.5% every week. It will just happen. And who gives that to you? Theta DK, and some people call it God. I don't know. Right? So you start with a 0.8% trade on a Tuesday. Always enter into trades which will give you only 1% returns, 0.9% returns, 1.1% returns. You will end up having 2% a week. And on a losing week, make sure that you cut short your losses and you do not lose more than 1%. That happens, you're making 1 to 2 returns, percentage returns a week, and that's 50% returns an annum after making all the losses. I'm looking at this year at 60-70%, or even probably more than that. Yeah. Yes, so
one quick question. I missed out when you said Tuesday morning or Tuesday evening.
Tuesday morning.
Morning, okay.
Morning. So it's more like when I have a conviction to enter. So I asked myself a question. Where are you sure that Nifty will not go up till by expiry? Where are you sure that Nifty will not go? So if Tuesday morning is a crazy opening, you're not sure about the market stability, I wait. I wait till Tuesday afternoon. Even if there is no stability in the market, I wait. I enter on a Wednesday morning. Even if I enter on a Thursday morning, I can make 1%. We all know that, right? I made 1% yesterday. So I enter on a Tuesday morning so that I can make higher returns and also I can mitigate risk if something happens, if something can happen on a Thursday.
Shariq, yeah. My question is, you said we start with 1%,
yeah.
But you say it will actually go up to 2%.
It will go even up to 2.5-3%.
How is that? The buy and sell premiums are fixed. So even if we wait till expiry...
No, you keep changing the positions, right? So I'll give you a scenario. So that's what I showed in the Excel sheet earlier. You start with an 18,500 call and a 17,500 put, right? And when, say, Nifty moved down, you won't be holding on to your 18,500 calls. You will be rolling down to 18,400 or 18,300. So that will be giving you higher returns. So adding on small 0.2% it will reach to 1.52%.
So if, like, initially you started off with saying it like a completely passive thing as well.
Yeah.
So if you get in on Tuesday morning, you hold it till Thursday expiry?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mostly I get a chance to adjust the positions. Because okay. Say, we enter on a Tuesday morning. What happened this week? Let's look into Nifty. You remember what happened to Nifty this week? So Nifty kept moving down, right?
Yes.
So what would we have done? I started the week with a very high 18. Ajay, we started with 18? Call 600, 700? 18,600 calls, I think I started. So when Nifty started moving down, I booked profits there. I sold an 18,500 call. When Nifty further moved, I had a 7,900 put as well. I held on to that till Thursday morning. I moved down my calls. The put was there. On Thursday, the put SL was hit. I exited the put there. I sold a lower put. That's also SL was said, but I sold calls heavily so that I could end up with profits. Again, it's pure money management. No tricks here.
Okay, thanks.
Sir, do you find any week we should not trade? Avoid any kind of trade you find any week, any...
Say, when I speak this to people, tell this to people, I say you have to stay away, say, on a budget week or inflation data from the US is coming, you stay away from the market. But it's okay when you trade every week and it's all discounted into the returns that you generate, right? So funny thing, I said all my, people in the community to stay away from the budget week. But I think the move started on a Monday or a Tuesday. So Thursday, I thought it wouldn't go up again. I sold some calls on Thursday. It went up again and did book losses. I think it's okay to go in every week because this is pretty non-directional. Stuff is supposed to go bad at times and you can definitely manage when it happens. So you can definitely do every week.
There's a week when the Bank Nifty was making around the budget time.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
Anytime you find from inside, I should have not...
Your voice is not clear, please.
You find any time from the inside that I should have not traded this week or...
Yeah, so the budget week again is something which I kind of regret. I mean, I did not enter on a Tuesday like I normally do, but I waited and entered on a Thursday and still it went bad. So,
okay.
Again, part of the system, right? I mean, it's okay. And when Nifty broke 17,000, so maybe you call it gambler's fallacy or what? I mean, Nifty just went up and up and up. I sold more and more calls and that's how I ended up losing a large amount in the first week of August. It happens.
Shariq, I have a question
Only
for
additions?
You.
No. Yeah.
A real simple one, like, what is the lowest level of VIX which we can go this at?
Lowest level of VIX
because I have personally experienced.
I didn't hear.
That VIX. When the VIX is near 12 and 11, when it goes there, option sellers take a heavy beating. So, like, would we be comfortable running the strategy at that level also or not?
So, I've been doing this for a very long time. So I have data, proper data in the last 6 months with a very steady capital so that, because when I talk this to a large crowd, I need to back it up so I can show that. So I have a very structured account where I have done. So last 6 months we are talking about, VIX has been 17 in the beginning, 20s in the beginning. And we are talking about March and April. Then it came down to 12. Now it's back to 17, 18 ranges. I've done every week, every single week. And that's where the 36% returns is.
All right.
Yeah, Shariq, I have some questions from the online audience. What would be the best hedge for Bank Nifty? As for Nifty, it is 150 points.
Yeah, sorry, I did not mention that. For Bank Nifty, the hedge should ideally be 500 points away. That's where you get the highest returns and the hedge benefits and everything associated, 500 points.
What is the strategy builder used by Shariq?
Oh, that's our strategy builder that we've developed in-house. So it's still in stealth mode. We haven't sent it out. Probably next time, DJ, we can do it here.
Okay. There is a point here. I'm not sure if I should mention this. Everybody should kick dash broker name. I'm happy and profitable after moving out of dash. Right. Anyway, we'll ignore that.
Yeah. No, to make sure things don't go wrong, I mean, I did that mention because for that specific reason. Otherwise, I love dash.
And you did not get dashed because of that.
To be politically right is very important. Easy.
There's one more question. It's incomplete. Can Shariq's last trade... That's it. So, strategy builder, you already touched on that. Okay. What if in case of one directional moment, if only one option is triggered?
What is it?
Not very clear, the question. What in the case of one directional moment, only one option triggered? I'm not able to get that as well.
Yeah, you shift your position basically. So whoever that asked that. So say it's a directional movement towards the upper side, your call option, SL is hit. Again, that is where a bit of discretion comes in. Again, going back to our story, if you're a foolish trader, you can stop trading there. You do not do anything with the capital deployed in the call set. Let it be there. You just manage your put set. Still, you can come out with minor losses in that week. But if you really have to, become a good trader, you can use your discretion and either sell a higher call or use that capital to sell more puts, which I did yesterday, right? Because till one point, I was still selling puts. But then when the trend was really clear, I took money away from it completely, started selling calls alone. So, yeah, that's where discretion comes in.
Okay, there are 5 messages, all from different people. I'm not able to figure it out. It says, Shariq rocks.
Yeah, thank you. Right.
That's it, I think.
Yeah, thank you, DJ.
We'll wind up now. Yeah. Okay, thanks. Thanks, Shariq, for this lovely presentation.
Let me just do some personal plugs. Right. So I do a daily show live on YouTube called The Stock Market Show, where I speak about the markets, what happened that day, what can happen the coming day. And I speak about my position. So again, I'm trying to build a community, and we internally in the community call it the famous 1% club, because I'm sure I'll be making a lot of millionaires with this 1% club. I'm absolutely sure about that. So yeah, welcoming you all to join the 1% club, where we're making 1% every single week, and this is where you can reach out to me. So thank you for being a wonderful audience, the online audience as well, and thank you DJ again for having me and having this wonderful event, which is Traders Carnival. So yeah, so DJ being considerate enough to speak in Malayalam to my audience. So, kandellarkum nannindu, I'm sure nattinu kore vere kaanunnundavunnu urappunde. Appo endayalum nammal saarna parayna karyangal thanne ivideyum parayunnullu. 1% undakkiyal namukku theerchayittum polikkan pattunnullathu urappayittulla karyam thanneyanu. So, let's focus on that. Nammada 1% club.
So,
adishaktam.
Yes. Can you repeat the same thing in Sanskrit, please, now?
Right.
Yeah. So, thank you very much, Harik. Yeah. Thanks a lot for this awesome presentation.
Yeah.
And I'm sure the audience enjoyed it. Okay. And this is the... I was just telling them just as we are entering that this is the Rahul Dravid kind of trading. Where you say 50% returns in a year and 1% to 2% returns in a week.
Yeah.
So, meaning...
But we do it in a Rahul Dravid kind of a way.
I agree with that principle, because I myself have tried it in crypto.
Oh, nice.
And it's worked phenomenally well.
Absolutely, yeah. Doing it in a Rahul Dravid style of way, but we're getting into centuries and double
centuries. I was working in a market which is open 24/7.
Right.
So I was getting the quantum of trades was much higher.
Right.
Like in a 45-day period, I got about 600.
So you're doing it in
trades.
A Brian Lara kind of a way, long innings.
Right? 499.
Awesome.
Yeah. So cool. Thank you. So,
yeah.
Thank you, Shariq. Thanks a lot.
Yeah.
Probably we'll reconnect again next year.
Yeah. We'll do that. So thank you again. Wishing you all the very best and hoping you all, or most of you, will be joining the 1% club.